we can stand for praise and worship this morning. We're going to sing about his resurrection power this morning as we're going into the Easter season. So I wanted to share this verse from Ephesians 1:18 through 21, and it's talking about that power. And it says, I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people, and his incomparably great power for us who believe. That power is the same as the mighty strength he exerted when he raised Christ from the dead and seated him at the right hand in heavenly realms, far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, and every name that is invoked, not only in the present age, but also in the one to come. Amen.
Thank you for the freedom that we have in you. worship you. We thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In Romans 12 and 1, it says, therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, because this is your true and proper worship. And I want to worship him with all that I am this morning. Hallelujah. We lift our hands in praise to you, Jesus, for your worthy. Hallelujah.
Give myself away.
praise, God, because you're worthy this morning, hallelujah. You're worthy of everything, God. And in Revelations 4 and 11, it says, you are worthy, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they were created and have their being. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus.
And all the elders cast. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory, hallelujah. You are worthy of it all. We worship you, for you are worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. You are worthy of it all. King Jesus, you are worthy of it all. We worship you, we worship you, for from you are all things, and to you are all things. You